is Charlotte Holland. Welcome to my TV show. It's called Selah. Selah is a Hebrew word. It means stop, pause, and think about it. It's pretty cool. Check it out. Do some research. Thank you so much for watching today. You're gonna get blessed. That's a promise. Thank you for watching in Detroit, Michigan on Comcast Cable TV 20. And also thank you very much for watching online on bgntvgospel.com. I pray for you every day. I want you to know that, and I want you to believe that. It's the truth. I wouldn't even tell you if it wasn't. Well, today we have my special guest, my cousin Paul Rhodes is here, and our topic is prayer, fasting, praise, and worship. So we're going to talk to you about that, and we want to change your life. We want to help people. We want to inspire you and motivate you. Before I get started, though, I want to make an announcement, and this is something coming up the day before Mother's Day, and it's really, really nice. It's the 16th annual Black Women's Business Expo. And it's Saturday, May 13th, 2017, from 11 a.m. until 6 p.m. at Greater Grace. The address is 23500 West 7 Mile Road. Admission is free. There's no charge. Praise God. And I'll be there. I'll have a prayer table there. You don't want to miss it. And Paul, thank yes. you for being here.
Sure. Always a pleasure and a blessing.
Yes. Yes, yes. And did you want to, before we get started, you want to say something about Sister Darice's book?
Yes. We were supposed to have another guest here also, Sister Darice Ray, but unfortunately she's under the weather and unable to make it here today. So I'd like you all to pray for her recovery. I think she has the flu. But she's also the author of a book called 7 Steps to a Successful Harvest. And this is a book that is a must read by all Christians, men and women. It tells you how to recover and to maintain every good and perfect gift that God has given you. It'll also tell you that God has a plan and a purpose for each one of us. And it'll show you how to find out what that plan and what that purpose is, how to put the plan and purpose into action, how to keep it going, how to have it grow, all done legitimately and without compromising your faith. Again, it's 7 Steps to a Successful Harvest. It can be purchased at Amazon.com. It's also available on Kindle Books. And if you'd like to contact the author, you can reach her because she's also has a ministry, Women Helping Other Women. And you can reach her at whow2llc@yahoo.com. And you can also reach her if you want to talk to her. Her phone number is, and I should have written this down so I wouldn't have to go through this.
That's okay.
It's area code 559-797-1365. So the email again is whow2llc@yahoo.com, rayoflifebooks.com, and area code 559-797-1365.
Amen. Well said. You got to get the book.
Yes, yes.
Now, as far as our topic, I wrote down James chapter 5 verse 16. I'm looking at it on my phone, and it says, confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that ye may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Now, that's a powerful, well, the word is powerful, period.
Amen.
Amen. But the part that it's like when you're praying for one another, it's saying that ye may be healed. Yes. It's letting you know that, I mean, I've already heard about the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much, but I just didn't even associate it with the part about and pray one for another that ye may be healed. I don't know why I didn't associate the two in the same scripture. It's always kind of like separate.
Mm-hmm.
But bottom line is power in prayer. And that's not nothing new.
Exactly, exactly. Prayer is our conversation with God.
Mm-hmm.
And you brought up James. It also says in James, you have not because you ask not.
See?
In prayer, we not only converse with God, but we let him know what we would like him to do for us. Even though he already knows what we need before mm-hmm. we even ask him, he still wants us to ask him for it. In addition to prayer being conversation, it doesn't always have to be asking God for something. You can be sitting down in your living room and just say, Lord, I don't want to ask you for anything. I just want to say thank you.
Amen.
Thank you for waking me up this morning. Thank you for whenever I open my refrigerator, there's food in there. Thank you that there's a roof over my head.
Yes.
God wants you to talk to him. He enjoys conversation with his daughters and his sons.
Amen. That's, you know, but you need to have a relationship with your daddy, your spiritual
yes.
father. He wants to communicate with us. He wants his family to spend time with him. He wants us to be connected and close to him. And I have a scripture in Isaiah chapter 65, verse 24. It says, it shall come to pass that before they call, I will answer. And while they are yet speaking, I will hear. That brings peace to my soul. You know, just knowing that the will of God and the plan of God, all that part of that is like he's got us.
Right. God, he's got your back. He's got what
right.
you need. He'll provide.
And he answers and he hears us.
Yes.
and we want that. Especially in this day and age.
Yes, yes.
There's a lot going on in the world.
Definitely, definitely.
You want to be connected to God, your spiritual Abba. Amen. And I know everybody has heard of, a lot of you, Jeremiah 29:11. But I'm going to go to Jeremiah 29:12-13. And we're still talking about prayer and fasting.
Yes.
And let me see if I can find. Oh, let's see. Yeah, Jeremiah 29:12-13. So, it's all good. We are here for you, to bless you, to encourage you. Let's see here. I am trying to get to it on my phone.
Okay, what was it again? I'll try to bring it up.
Jeremiah 29:12.
Jeremiah 29:12.
Mm-hmm, and 13.
Okay.
It says, then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And verse 13 says, and ye shall seek me and find me, and when ye shall search for me with all your heart. So it's a heart issue.
Yes.
If he's not in your heart, it's not real. You know, and that close, intimate relationship, it has to involve the heart. You're talking on the inside. Mm-hmm. And it's saying, then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me. So he wants us to pray.
Always, always, always. And he will always hear your voice when you call on his name.
Mm-hmm.
If you have that relationship with him, that's the main thing. You have to have that personal relationship with God in order for him to hear you. And the Bible also says, be anxious in nothing, but always pray in thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
Thanking God for what he's done for you. Thanking him for everything that he's given you. Those kind of prayers are sweet, sweet, sweet sounds
mm-hmm.
in the ears of God.
Yes, yes. And it's amazing you just said the ears of God. Now, this scripture is in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 12. And it says, for the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil.
Mm-hmm.
We better not do evil.
<That's right.
laughs> We don't want him to be against us.
Against us, exactly. Exactly.
We want to be on his side, his good side, right?
Exactly.
Amen.
Exactly.
But it's like it's saying, the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous. He's seeing us. Even when we're sleeping.
When we're sleeping, yes.
He's watching over us. And his ears are open unto our prayers. So whenever we want to talk to him, we don't have to charge our phone. We don't have to wait on hold. We don't have to stand in line.
Never have to make an appointment.
Mm-mm.
He's always available and ready.
Praise the Lord. It says that his ears are open unto our prayers. And it says, but the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. So, we don't want to upset you, but if you do evil, he knows that too.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And it's some consequences in that.
Yes.
That's a danger zone.
Yes. Yes.
That's
yes.
The red zone. Get out of there. And
what's done in the dark always comes to the light.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And we could just say so much about prayer. Well, you know, prayer changes things.
Yes.
Prayer makes a difference in the world. I know I feel better when I pray.
Yes, yes. Always.
I feel good just knowing that he hears my prayers.
Mm-hmm.
That I'm talking to him. And he's talking to me because I actually hear his voice.
Yes.
I've gotten close enough to God where I can hear his voice. It's heaven on earth.
Earth, yes.
It's heaven on earth to hear his voice or to get into his presence, his holy presence. Now,
and I always feel a lot better after praying too. It's like a heavy burden is lifted up off your shoulders. Because the Bible says, cast all your cares upon him,
mm-hmm.
for he cares for you.
That's right. Now, I love that scripture. Because if you got something bothering you, something going on,
take it to him and leave it. He'll take care of it.
Right. And you got to believe that, though.
Yes, exactly.
Because if you don't believe that, then you're not giving it to him. And you're going to try to handle it yourself. And it might not work. I'm going to go to Psalm 103:2 and see what that says. Let me see. I got it written down. Oh, that's saying, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. And I mean, there are a lot of benefits.
Benefits, yes, they are. Yes.
Unlimited. Unlimited. And it's just none other. There's no greater. I mean, the blessings of God, the love of God. He's just awesome.
Awesome, yes.
He's always there. He is with you too. Call on him and trust him and believe his word. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And I'm going to go to Psalm chapter 9, verse 1. And let me see here. And so we're talking about prayer and praise and fasting and worship. Well, this one is talking about praise in Psalm chapter 9, verse 1. It says, I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will show forth all thy marvelous works. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It says, I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. He wants our hearts to praise him. Oh, he deserves it. He's worthy, right?
Amen. Amen. Yes, he
is. If he's been good to you, if he's done anything for you.
Right.
And we wouldn't be here today.
If it was not, yes, for the Lord.
That's right. So somebody out there needs to hear this. Get your praise on. Thank him. When you even wake up, you need to be praising God.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
Especially if you're in your right mind and you got a roof over your head.
That's right. That's right.
And you ain't in the hospital.
Yes, right. And when God answers your prayers, you're supposed to thank him, tell other people that he's answered your prayers, and then go out and praise him. Let everybody know.
Mm-hmm.
How good the Lord has been to you. Let everybody know all the good things that God has done for you.
Yes.
Praise is like music to God's ears. He loves when we praise him. In fact, the Psalms, the majority of the Psalms are praises to God. They start off with, I will praise the Lord. I will bless the Lord. So that's what. Praising God is part of the Christian fellowship with him.
Yes, 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 indeed. It should be automatic.
Yes.
You shouldn't have to think about it. You should do it. It's every day. Thank the Lord.
Like breathing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's right. Because he's the reason why you breathe.
Another reason to praise him.
That's right. Yes. There's so many, to count the blessings of God.
Yes.
They're unlimited.
Unlimited.
We can't even count them all. We probably take some of them for granted.
Right.
But help me, Lord, with that. I want to do better. But make sure you thank the Lord every day. Because he is good.
All the time.
All the time. Now I'm going to 2 Samuel chapter 22 and 4. Let's see, where did I go? Oh, okay. It says, I will call on the Lord who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. Wow. Now that's deep right there.
Yes, yes.
It says, now here we are praising. But at the same time, he's including that we're being saved from our enemies.
From our enemies. Another reason to praise God.
For right.
Saving you from your enemies.
Yes.
For saving you from going to hell.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right. So that's in 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 4. I'll read it again. I will call on the Lord who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies. Now, I didn't connect that before.
Okay.
The praise, praising God and being saved from your enemies. That's powerful.
Yeah, but yes, it is.
I mean, I'm learning too. So, make sure you get some paper and pen and take some notes. Wow. That is something. And when I think of, I'm going to go to Psalm 95, 6 and 7. Let me see here. And I say, brother, we are just blessed to be here.
Amen. Yes, we are.
Mm-mm-mm. So blessed. And it's beautiful outside.
Wonderful day, yes.
And I thank God for it.
Yes.
I
praise God for the good weather.
Yes. Yes. I'm telling you, because you know we're coming out of the winter, and we're into the spring, and the grass is green out. When I opened the door today, I saw green grass. I'm like, wow. So, and I saw birds.
Springtime is
here. I heard the birds, so I'm like, okay, praise God for my ears.
Yes.
I don't want to take anything for granted. Okay, I said Psalm 95, verse 6 and 7, right? Let me see. I'm talking. All right. 95. Psalm 95. And that's 6 and 7. Okay, now we're still talking. Our topic is pray and fasting and worship and praise. Okay, this one is saying, oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. So this is talking worship here.
Yes.
And you notice that it's saying, let us worship and bow down. So, I mean, that's like a little bit different. It's showing that the praise and the worship are not the same.
Right. Exactly.
And it says, let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker. He's our Maker. And He's the creator of the whole universe. But He's our Maker. And He's our spiritual Father. So we should worship Him.
Worship and adore Him, yes.
Yes.
That's one of the main reasons we were created, is to worship God.
Amen.
God loves worship. Mm-hmm. He loves when His children worship Him. And it's something that, in addition to praise, is what we should do automatically. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't have to be every Sunday at church. You can worship God in your home. You can worship God while you're driving on your way to work. Listening to the Bible. On listening to some religious programs while you riding to work is a way of worshiping God.
Well, that is so true. But just make sure you include worship.
Yes.
In your daily walk. Yes. And now this one is Luke chapter 4, verse 8. It says, and Jesus answered and said unto him, get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and Him only shalt thou serve. That's powerful.
That's powerful, yes.
You know, I mean, first of all, He's telling you got power to tell Satan, get behind me. And this is Jesus speaking. And He said, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God.
And no other gods. And no other gods also means don't put things like temporal things before God, money, cars, jewelry, homes. Those things are temporal and can be taken away at the blink of an eye.
Mm-hmm.
All our attention and all our adoration is supposed to be placed on God and God alone.
That's true. That is so true. And you know, when I'm thinking of switching around a little bit because of the time, but the when you think of fasting, that's deep.
Yes.
And that could take a while. and it's abstaining from food or drink in order for you to stay closer and more focused
on the Lord. Yes.
On the Lord. And I strongly suggest that you fast and pray, especially if you have something heavy on you.
On your mind, yes.
You know, and something stressing you, or if the enemy is trying to steal your joy and he's trying to tear you down. Anyway, in Luke chapter 2, verse 37, it talks about the widow who she departed not from the temple, but served God with fasting and prayers day and night. You know, I mean, that was probably her call. Mm-hmm. You know, so it says 84 years. But to fast is kind of, like I said, abstaining, giving up, making a sacrifice.
Right.
It doesn't just have to be food or drink.
Exactly.
It could be like, say, I enjoy texting. I can stop texting and do that, mm-hmm. call that a fast.
Okay, right.
And spend that time with God. Amen?
Amen. Yeah. And as we're coming out of the season that some churches call Lent, where they commemorate the 40 days and 40 nights that Jesus spent in the wilderness, mm-hmm. and was tempted by the devil, a lot of people will give up, like you said, something, meat, for example, or sweets, or texting, mm-hmm. social media, mm-hmm. something that to show God that they are serious about their relationship with Him. And that they want to get closer to Him. And we do that by fasting.
That's right. That is so true. Well, you know what? Our time is running out. But we hope and pray that you got blessed by this program. Because that's our plan.
Our plan, yes.
That's our goal. That's our intention. God bless you out there. And your families. Your friends. And just continue to read your Bible. And if you don't have a church home, or if you don't know the Lord and you're not saved, then give me a call. I'm Charlotte, 248-312-9945. I'll be more than happy to help in any way that I can. I love the Lord with my whole heart and my whole soul, and with all my strength and mind. And I love you, because He says, love our neighbors
as
ourselves. Selah. Like I said, stop, pause, and think about it.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.